PyVision is a great way for viewing continuous process data. But sometimes you want to compare data for specific events, like batches or downtime, in order to draw meaningful conclusions. Let's see how we might do that. Comparing event frames is all about analyzing a situation, understanding what is happening, and acquiring actionable intelligence to report back to managers and support staff. This is a display in PyVision that shows us the attributes of our mixing and storage tanks. Clicking here takes us to the events pane, showing us all the event frames that occurred within the start and end time of the display. In order to show up here, event frames need to have been defined in the asset framework. For more information, check out our event frames playlist linked in the description. The event that's selected in the events pane will have the start time and end time displayed, and will also have its attributes displayed in the attributes pane. I can change the time range of my entire display to the time range of the event by simply right-clicking and selecting Apply Time Range. If I want more information about these events, I can right-click and select Event Details. What I'll get is a trend that has all the time series attributes of that event, and a table with all the attributes of the event. Now, I might want to compare this event to similar events that have occurred in the past. I right-click and select Compare Similar Events by Type, and obtain the whole list of trends right here. The events shown are the event that I selected, and then 10 events of the same type and referenced asset that occurred previously. At the bottom here, there is a bar chart of all the displayed events, with a bar size reflecting event duration. You can also right-click an event to pin that event. Pinned events remain at the top of the list for reference, even if you perform another event search through Edit Search Criteria. If I find that I have too much data here, what I can do is hide a couple of these events by right-clicking, selecting Hide Event. So let me do that for a couple of these. To highlight an event to focus on, I can simply click on it here. Now, I can see that in all the trends, that event is highlighted. If I want to explore the data of an attribute that isn't visualized here, I can open the Attributes pane by clicking on this gray bar here. I can then drag and drop any of these on the list of trends. So these PyVision features allow me to compare attributes across events and identify the issues that may be affecting my assets. How have you used this feature in your industry? Let us know in the comments. And before you go, don't forget to like and subscribe.